In 1850, Xian Feng became the emperor. 1 year later, the first Ba Qi Xuan Xiu was held. Because Xian Feng's wife passed away 1 month before Xian Feng became the emperor, so the girls took in this Xuan Xiu had a chance to be the empress. Both Cian and Cixi came into the inner court through this Xuan Xiu. Cixi came into the inner court in 1851. She just got a lower rank concubine title, Lan Guiren, the noble lady Lan, because she was from a common family. 3 years later, she was promoted to Yi Pin, the imperial concubine Yi. In 1856, because of giving birth Xian Feng's first son, Cixi was promoted to Yi Fei, the consort Yi. 1 year later, she became Yi Guifei, the noble consort Yi. This was the highest rank Cixi got when Xian Feng was alive. Cixi spent 6 years to be promoted from the noble lady to the noble consort. This speed was really fast in Qing Dynasty inner court. But if compare it with Cian's promotion speed, Cixi's promotion speed seems not so fast. Cian came into the inner court 6 months after Cixi, but Cian immediately got a higher rank consort title, Zhen Pin, the imperial concubine Zhen. 3 months later, Cian was promoted to Zhen Guifei, the noble consort Zhen. After another month, Cian became the empress. Cian was promoted from the imperial concubine to the empress only using 4 months. Cian's family background was a very important reason to help her to be promoted so fast. Cian was from the Nihulu Shi. Before her, there were already 5 empresses came from this family. Cian was born by his father's concubine, but she was well educated. Cian became the empress when she was only 15 years old. But as the host of the inner court, she arranged everything orderly. Because of her high quality work, the Emperor Xian Feng really respected her. Cian also was a great role model. She never accepted gifts from the ministers. In Xian Feng's time, because Qing army lost in several wars, the Qing government had to pay huge amount of money to victorious countries. Qing government fall in financial difficulty. To help the country, Cian didn't wear luxury decorations and decreased the daily dishes from 32 to 24. In 1860, the British and French forces went on to loot and burned Yuan Ming Yuan, the old summer palace, and Yi He Yuan, the summer palace. Upon getting this news, the Emperor Xian Feng, bringing the royal family, escaped to Chengde Bi Shu Shanzhuang, Chengde Mountain Resort. Xian Feng spent his last days in there and passed away on August 1861. Xian Feng's surviving 6-year-old Zhai Chen inherited the crown. At day of death of Xian Feng, Cian, as the late empress, automatically became the empress daughter, called Mu Hou Huang Tai Hou. Cixi was promoted to Yi Huang Gui Tai Fei. The Imperial Noble Consort Dowager Yi. One day later, Cixi, as the biological mother of the new emperor, was promoted to the empress dowager, called Sheng Mu Huang Tai Hou. Although both Cian and Cixi were empress dowagers, Cian's rank was higher than Cixi, because Cian was the empress, while Cixi was a concubine. Besides, Cian was truly authorized by Xian Feng to influence the political decisions. Cixi didn't. Before this, Xian Feng knew that his son was too young to rule the country, so he elected 8 ministers as regents to rule the country when the emperor was young. Meanwhile, Xian Feng had 2 stamps, Yu Shang and Tong Dao Tang. The orders from the 8 regions wasn't effective without the 2 stamps. Xian Feng gave the stamp Yu Shang to Cian and gave the stamp Tong Dao Tang to the young emperor. Because the emperor was too young, stamp Tong Dao Tang was temporarily used by Cixi. When Cian was alive, all important decisions were made by Cian. Cian was the actual ruler of the court. Thank you for watching this video. In next video, let's see the stories between 2 empress dowagers in Tongzhi's time.